So what, you're not gonna stop?
Hey, I didn't see you.
Okay, well, as long as you're not trying to avoid me.
Why would I do that?
Well, I told you that I wanted a chance to be with you, and I thought maybe that might make you feel uncomfortable.
Maybe a little.
You know that wasn't my intention. The last thing I want to do is scare you away.
Just losing our friendship on top of everything else that's happened would send me screaming right over the edge. And I don't want to send you any mixed signals.
Okay. Signals? There's no signals one way or the other. It's... Listen, you know what? It's a perfect day. How about a little, no pressure, but a little Chuck and Bob's homemade ice cream? Listen, let's let fate decide. Heads, I see a double scoop of cherry mocha chunk in your future, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Deal?
Mm-hmm. Boy, you don't waste any time, do you, brother?
Yeah, what's that supposed to mean? Just moving right in on Emily, aren't you? You know what difference does it make to you?
There's nothing going on. Lucky and I are friends, just like always. Excuse me.
Let me tell you something. You made it perfectly clear you want nothing to do with me or Emily, all right? That means whatever you have to say means nothing.
Did you tell Emily that you offered to take
it? Leave it alone, Nicholas, all right? You've hurt her enough. Hey, are you all right? What happened?
My grandmother died last night.
It's gonna be okay. I'm so sorry.
I can't believe she's gone. Well, what are any of us gonna do without her? My grandmother was our rock. The one who never faltered no matter what horrible thing was happening. I know I have to go through with the chemo. It's the best way to fight the cancer, but my mother died of cancer, and I could be dying too, Grandmother.
Emily, you are going to live. You have to believe that and choose to fight for your life.
All right, Jason, I have to find him.
Come on, I'll take care of it.
Okay.
Emily, sorry for your loss.
I was supposed to marry Ned at one time, and I bolted. At the chapel, I ran in my big poofy gown out the door, running for my life, and left Ned standing there humiliated and angry and hurt. Lila, who adored Ned, I'm quite certain was furious with me. But that woman was so filled with grace that she forgave me anyway, more than once. How's Emily?
Devastated. It's hard to see her hurt like that.
Hey, Sam. I probably shouldn't have shown up here. I don't think anyone followed
me. No, that's okay. Just tell me. What?
I didn't want to call you. That's how I heard her over the phone. Grandmother's dead. She passed away last night in her sleep.
You should drink some tea. You look pale.
You know, I never drank tea before I came to live with the Quartermains. My birth mom drank coffee in the morning and soda and lemonade when it got hot. And I started drinking tea with grandmother.
In her sitting room in the afternoons.
That.
Yeah, after, you know, I left the house, I had that job on the pier, and you tracked me down.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted my permission to tell grandmother I was alive and not eating out of garbage cans.
Grandfather was so mad at you. He'd go on and on about how you were a disgrace and a couple of weeks of sleeping in doorways would teach you some respect. And grandmother didn't want to hear it. She'd say, Edward, that will be quite enough. And he'd shut right up. I remember I was so furious at him, and she said that it was his way of showing that he loved you.
And she was always good at that. Knowing what people meant instead of what they said.
Yeah, I could talk to her about anything. And we'd just sit there in the afternoons and sew, and I felt so lucky because she was the kind of grandmother that you dream of having. You know, one who needlepoints and serves you tea and has the time to listen.
She was lucky to have you, too. I mean, all those days after school. You know, you could have been doing anything else, and you took the time to be with her.
I didn't do anything great.
Yeah, you did. You gave her what I didn't. You gave her your time.
Justice with the arrangements.
Mother, come here. Come here.
Sweetheart, this will have to do.
No, please, just stop. Just stop. I'm right here. Just stop.
Oh, God. I'm so sorry. It's so good to see you. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're here too, Mother.
Mom? You okay?
I'll have to be, won't I? We'll all have to be okay without her. Well, at least she didn't suffer. You know, there's something wonderful about just passing in your sleep. It's like, well, it's like the angels just came and got her.
You know that she was thinking about you up until the very end. I mean, just yesterday she was talking to Cook about your anniversary. She wanted to have a celebration dinner to honor the things you still have after all you've been through.
Thank you for finding him, Emily.
Jason needed to come.
I can't stay.
It's okay. You just being here makes all the difference to Edward.
It means everything to us, Jason. Thank you.
Of your grandmother. You have her strength, her determination. You have her eyes. At least you had the decency not to get shot to death. Be sentenced to life in prison while your grandmother was still here.
I'm grateful for that.
Your grandmother was the only reason you gave this family the time of day. And for that, I'm grateful.
My dad used to call Lila an honorary spinster.
Luke was shameless in the way he flirted with her.
And grandmother flirted right back.
Yeah.
It drove grandfather crazy.
My mother, she loved her too. Yeah, if she could be here.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you for being here.
I wouldn't be anyplace else.
Have you had anything to eat?
I'm not hungry.
Let me know if I can get you anything, and I mean it, anything at all. Well, would you look at this charming tableau? All of us, gathered here together, just like a real family. And all it took was my mother's death.
Tracy, stop and think. Is this tantrum you're about to throw really necessary?
Or appropriate? Appropriate? The hell with appropriate. Don't you realize that's what's wrong with this picture? This is not a fair representation of what this family really is, which is far from appropriate. I deeply resent the hypocrisy that's on display in my dead mother's name.
Tracy, knock it off.
Oh, my God. You stay out of it, you little gutter snipe. Why the hell are you here anyway?
Tracy! Listen to me. This is your pain. It's not your anger. Please. Please don't attack the family. Not today. Please.
I just want my mommy!
I know.
I want my mommy!
Thanks for meeting me.
Ah, you knew I would. Are you okay?
I miss grandmother. I'm having a hard time wrapping my mind around the fact that she's gone.
I know, me too.
I want to do something that grandmother would want. And that means taking care of the family. The only catch is, I'll need your help.
Emily, I loved Lila. And I want to help you. God knows in any way that I can. But when it comes to the family, there's just not a whole lot that I can do. I went to the house. I'll be at the funeral. I can share the Quartermain's pain and loss. Because I feel it. As far as being some kind of comfort to them, I don't even know how to do that.
All you have to do is show up, Jace, I'm not asking you to move in. Just be a presence in their lives. Everyone knows grandmother's the only reason you ever went near that house or had a civil word to say to any one of them. And now she's gone. And they've not only lost the heart and soul of our family, they've lost their last connection to you. And it scares them, Jace. Whether they burden you with that fear or not, please, just stay in touch. That's all I'm asking.
You're the one I'm worried about. And you and Lila were so close. You have your own pain to work through. Don't get so caught up in taking care of everybody else that you forget to take care of yourself.
I get it. I have you to come to lean on. That's so much more than the rest of them have.
Em, I'm so sorry to hear about Lila. Is there anything at all I can do for you?
No, have a seat. That's the hardest part. It's irretrievable, and there's absolutely nothing anyone can do but feel her loss and wish that there were something or anything that they could do to pay appropriate tribute to who grandmother was and what she left behind.
I realize that a piece of chocolate cake is not the same as donating thousands to a worthy cause in Lila's name, but it is a treat to be savored. Oh. And Lila liked those.
Yes, she did. Thank you, Bobby. Do you want to have a seat?
Oh, thanks. Well, hope you're prepared, because you got your work cut out for you.
How do I know that you're referring to my family?
I've watched Lila hold the Quartermains together for decades. And I've watched her train you to do the same. The mantle has passed.
Jeez, no pressure or anything.
Managing your family takes strength, patience, and a fierce sense of humor. And it also comes in handy if you're able to convince people to do things they don't want to do.
Like getting Jason to let the family stay at Michael's baptism.
Oh, when those church doors opened and the entire Quartermain contingent came storming down the aisle, I thought I would die.
Jason was ready to throw them all out.
Jason, dear, no one can argue with your decision to exclude us. It has good sense and painful experience on its side. But if this ceremony is allowed to go on without incident, in silence and uninterrupted, would you consider throwing us out a little later, please?
And even I couldn't believe it when Grandmother got Jason to back down.
Gentle persuasion. That was Lila's special gift. And she mastered it. Now she's passed it on to you. So use it wisely, Emily. Do what Lila would have wanted.
Oh, hi. Great. A distraction.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to write Lila's obituary, and I am failing miserably. I mean, it should be easy, right? Just a list, where she was born, where she grew up, all her children, clubs she belonged to, charities she supported. I mean, it's an entire life that's condensed into a couple of paragraphs that are fitting into the Port Charles Herald. It doesn't even begin to describe her.
Don't even put that pressure on yourself, Mom. I mean, everyone who knew and loved Grandmother knows that she defies description. And besides, she couldn't abide obituaries. She called them posthumous bragging. I'm inclined to agree.
You and Lila discussed obituaries?
Yeah, I don't think there was anything we didn't cover over the years.
You want to know something I haven't told anybody?
Sure.
I was so jealous of your relationship with Lila. I wanted to be your role model. I wanted to be the woman that you came to with your deepest feelings. And now all I can do is just thank God that you had the benefit of her grace and her wisdom for as long as you did.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. You're staying home today, are you?
She's hovering.
Not true. It helps me to be with my parents.
Really? I think you realize how much it helps us to be with you. You're such a comfort, sweetie. I wish I could be the same for my own father. Another example of how I'm nothing like my father? He is stoic to the point of indifference.
No, you know that's not true.
Well, grandfather's in shock. His grief is so big he doesn't have a place for it yet.
But you know, in a way, I envy him being able to keep his pain at a distance. I feel the loss to the depths of my soul.
And that's because you loved her. And not just with words. With your life. You kept her a constant in your life, Alan, and your children's. You were a wonderful son.
I did love her so much. I hope she knew. I hope it was good enough. I dread the idea of having to bury my mother tomorrow.
I know.
Hey!
Oh, what a surprise! Oh,
what are you doing here? Not that I'm complaining.
My grandparents. And Jason thought you'd like to see me.
Well, he was right. I'm really glad to see you.
Be okay if I got a hug?
Sure.
Thank you.
You're
welcome. It is so good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Hey, I came as soon as I got your message. Is everything okay?
No. I feel like a ride. You know, a bike ride through the woods down to the skating pond. I just want to... I want to put my feet in the water, you know? Laugh about something stupid, you know? Maybe even a little water fight. I need to do all these things with you. Because you lived it with me.
How'd you know? That's exactly what I need to.
Don't just stand there. Tell your harpy wife she has no right.
Oh, I have every right. This is my house.
I gave it to you.
Because you're an idiot. Who builds a family estate, then gives it away lock, stock, and barrel to a social-climbing money grubber who's only marrying you so she can carry on an affair with her married lover?
I can't believe you would bring up Rick Weber. Look at the way it just rolls off your tongue after all these years.
The man is dead.
The man is probably AJ's father. Okay, forget the reception. Alice!
Speaking of the prodigal son... Does the little swindler even know that his grandmother died? You'd think with all the money he stole from us, he could afford a nice big bouquet.
Do you need something, Dr. Quartermain?
Tracy is leaving. Would you pack her... No, wait a minute. Would you open her bedroom window and throw everything she owns out onto the lawn?
Monica, I think you're going too far.
She deserves it.
We're having guests after the memorial. We don't want people tripping over Tracy's underwear.
Oh, I can pack her up. No problemo.
You touch one of my things, I have you arrested for theft.
What the devil is going on here?
Your daughter-in-law is threatening to throw me out.
It is not
what
a threat.
What is going on?
I'm being attacked.
You're the attacker. You're an abrasive shrew. You won't give any of us a...
Could you tone it down a notch, please? She's obviously in a lot of pain.
So are the rest of us, and all we're trying to do is just grieve for my...
We are all grieving. But some of us have the backbone to carry on.
Mother, why are you picking a fight today?
I demand that you side with me. You are my son. I want your loyalty and your support.
Well, loyalty and support go hand in hand.
Oh,
and what have you done to never deserve one iota?
The refugee from the trailer park who was an embarrassment to my mother.
Hey! Listen to me. You do not talk to my mother that way.
And you know what? Nothing hurt my mother more than when she took you away and raised you as a replica of herself.
My mother, why are you doing this? Was proud of Brookie. In fact, she loved everybody in this family equally, although God knows how she managed to love you.
An insult thrown, an insult returned. Why don't we all retreat to neutral corners and try to remember what this day is all about?
We? You're not a Quartermain.
Justice is much my grandson as Dylan is.
Look, we're wasting time here. Alice, go upstairs and pack Tracy's bag.
Oh, no, please. Enough. We need to respect each other's grief.
That means showing a little extra patience.
So does that mean I get to pack her up?
Grandmother would want her here, so I think she should stay.
All right. For Lila.
All right. Now that that's settled, we need to get to the church.
Excuse me?
I'm sorry I picked a fight with you on the day of our mother's memorial. It's just that all those people keep going on and on about how much they loved her, and they all have some stupid personal memory to share. She wasn't their mother. She was our mother. Yours and mine. And that's gone now. It's all gone. The wallpaper in my bedroom. The dress she bought me for my first cotillion. The family vacation when you fell in the lake.
You pushed me.
I know. And then she pushed me. And then she dove in after us.
And then we all walked out of the lake together, holding hands.
And she ruined her silk dress and her alligator shoes. And she was laughing. Then I thought to myself,
the best mother in the world.
How you doing?
Oh, we had a screaming fight at the house. I got everyone's adrenaline pumping.
Emily got everybody calmed down and out the door, which isn't easy because it was such a hard group to manage.
What do you mean they? You were in there yelling too?
Don't remind me.
It's okay. Long, loud, complicated arguments that don't resolve anything are a Quartermain tradition, and like it or not, you're one of the family.
We have come together to celebrate the life of a remarkable woman. Lila Morgan Quartermain was loved by every person in this building. That's not an exaggeration or a pleasantry. It's a simple statement of fact.
I came into the Quartermain family many years ago. Quite a formidable group. I have to say, at first, I didn't love most of them. I take that back. I didn't like most of them very much at first. Lila was the exception. She was warm, she was gracious, and most of all, she was welcoming from the moment we met.
There are so many superlatives to describe my mother: kind and generous and loving and beautiful. Oh, God, was she beautiful. I never met a person who didn't like her, which I understand. But she liked everybody, which I'll never understand. She laughed. She loved with an open heart, and it was returned in kind by her family and her friends. She was the best.
When I was 14 years old, I overheard two friends of my mother trying to figure out how a woman as delightful as Lila Quatermain could have raised me. A sentiment that I'm sure has been echoed by many people over the years. She always saw the best in me. And when I disappointed her, which happened frequently, she would express her displeasure mildly, and then she would tell me she loved me anyway. That love has sustained me my whole life. She embodied the elegance of her generation while at the same time rising above them to pursue her own goals. She had faith in herself. She was a unique individual. She never stopped learning. And I, in turn, will honor her by learning from her.
My grandmother was the first person, actually she was the only person, to truly understand that I loved to perform. And I think it's because she was also a performer, very gifted. Because I know there were times when she was too tired or discouraged or just plain fed up to be all that we needed her to be and expected her to be. And that was smiling, serene, wise Lila Quatermain. She was always there for us, for me, to make things better. She dug deep and found the resources to give us the best of herself. That was her gift. And we are all better for it.
There's nothing that I can say about my grandmother that someone else hasn't already said better. I missed the part of her life where she walked and danced. I met my grandmother when she was in a wheelchair, but her spirit was free. She encouraged me to try things, to take chances. She warned me that I might get hurt along the way, but she guaranteed that it would be worth the trip. She wanted me to find true love. She said that it had been the sustaining grace of her life. I didn't say goodbye to my grandmother. She was looking out the window of her sitting room, and I waved as I left the house. And I wish now that I'd gone upstairs and kissed her. I wish that I had told her that I loved her, but I know that she knew.
Everyone here wants to pay tribute to Lila. And that's how you do it. You tell someone you love them one extra time. You take the extra 30 seconds to go upstairs and make sure they know. Make sure you tell them how much they mean to you.
Join God and all his angels in everlasting life. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
May I thank you all for coming here today. My wife would be so moved by this outpouring of love. She so loved you all in return. I believe there is a heaven. And I believe she's there now. Pleased. Maybe a little embarrassed by all the attention. But I know she understands how deeply she touched us all. And how irreplaceable she is in all our lives.
Should we get to work, dear?
May your soul be blessed. May your body
love you, my son.
May you find your way in peace.
Oh, tell me, pretty maiden, are there any more at home like you?
There are a few, kind sir. Some flirty girls and very pretty too.
Did you hear that call of angels one and all?
Oh, that's a wonderful idea. And I know exactly what song.
I've grown accustomed to the trace of something in the air. Accustomed to her face.
All I can say, Lila, is wherever I do go, you will always be with me.
May you find your way in peace.
Did I tell you we're great today at the service?
I'm not even sure what I said. It's all a blur.
Tell someone you left them one extra time.
I do remember saying that. Trying to explain that time is precious. Like Nicholas has forgotten that. Like he's forgotten so much. He doesn't realize that he's wasting time he wasn't promised. You know, pushing people away without any guarantee that they'll be with him tomorrow.
Yeah, well, he's lost my game.
What do you mean?
Emily, listen, if it wasn't for the accident and all of Mary's lies, you'd be with Nicholas. And I never would have had the chance to fall in love with you. And I am in love with you, Emily. No, you know what? Just don't say a word. I know that it makes you uncomfortable. You know what? We've always been truthful with one another, and it's not going to change.
Love Nicholas, despite everything, and
you gotta see what happens with him. You know what? I get it. But even if the two of you got back together, I'd still be in love with you.
And I want a chance to win you back.
You never had me.
You told me you loved me. You slipped this ring on my finger, and you said those words.
I thought I was your husband, and now I know the truth.
Emily's not giving up on you. Neither am I. Is her love more important to you than mine?
Nicholas? That's the reason you're hanging out with your kidnapper? We'd gladly arrest you if my brother would press charges.
I'm sorry. I thought I was
No,
helping.
Nicholas needed his family and friends, but you kept him hidden from all of us. You know what? I came to you. I came to you the night of the accident.
So
I showed
sorry.
You a picture
I know,
of
I...
Nicholas, and you said you didn't even see him.
I at the time, thought he needed Lucky. His rest and that...
No,
that
you could... took advantage of Nicholas, all right? He was a prisoner in your home.
Lucky.
You stole my brother,
stop.
And now he's a stranger to me.
Stop. Lucky.
You know what? Stop.
That's enough.
No, you stop.
That's
you...
enough, Lucky. Stop.
I don't blame him. I blame you. You're a criminal. You deserve to be thrown in jail for what you've done. Proud of yourself? Huh? I'm the one who can't stand the sight of you. Be mad at me, not her.
Mary stole your life. How can you defend her?
She doesn't have anything to do with the choices I'm making right now. What? Of course she does. You would have known who you were months ago if she hadn't lied.
You all lied. All of you.
We were trying to protect you. Just save it, will you? I lost my memory, not my intelligence.
You could have gone into shock if we'd suddenly told you that your whole life was a lie.
Emily, it's my life. What, I don't get a vote?
Yeah, okay, so we were torn, and we were just trying to do what was best.
Do you have any idea how holier-than-thou that sounds? Come on.
What Mary did was crazy. Why can't you see that? Why don't you get that it's outrageous for a woman to find a complete stranger and then proceed to fill him with lies about who he is and instead about keeping him away from anyone who might be able to tell him the truth?
Look, she was wrong, okay? She was wrong. I know that, but so were the both of you. And you two were supposed to be the ones who loved me.
Nicholas.
I thought I told you I want nothing to do with you, Emily.
Message received. But Lucky's your brother. He loves you.
Certainly got a strange way of showing it.
Nicholas, it is killing him to be at odds with you, and the way you're treating him isn't fair.
Fair? Well, fairness doesn't seem to be a top priority for any of us here,
You keep saying how angry you are that we lied to you.
Well, Lucky didn't want to. I'm the one who told him it might be traumatic for you to know the truth. I made him swear not to tell you. So if you want to be mad at someone, be mad at me.
That won't be a problem.
It kills me to see you and Lucky fighting like this after everything you went through to be brothers. Your families try to pit you against each other, but you and Lucky, you refuse to be part of their stupid, endless fight. And you grew to love each other, maybe even more than if you'd grown up in the same household.
Even if I get my memory back, even if I do, my life isn't going to be magically restored to the way it was.
I know that. I am just saying that
you... What? That you what? Do you want me to patch things up with my brother? Because you're wasting your time. But hey, if you want my blessing for you and him, go ahead. You got it.
Friend, you're the man I'm in love with.
Emily, you can say that 1,000 times.
Of course, I'd like to get back what we had. But it's more important that you don't do anything that the old Nicholas would regret.
That's not my concern
right now. It should be, because your memory isn't lost, and you may still remember who you are and how much you were loved. I spent the entire day at a funeral watching people forgive each other and seeing how their lives changed. Like, I want your life to change.
I can't live up to this person you keep describing.
You are a man of compassion. You always saw things from the other person's perspective, and I want you to recapture that. Not for me, but for yourself. And I...
Blacked out. You could have hurt yourself, and you probably would have had I not caught you. You need to go to the hospital, get checked out by a doctor.
I passed out from exhaustion. I was confused for a moment, but I'm clear now.
But it doesn't hurt to check, okay? Just check.
Look, my grandmother's memorial was today. I've been upset. I haven't been eating or sleeping properly. That's all. I'll just go home now. I'll have a sandwich and a glass of milk.
You probably are fine, but probably is not good enough, right? It doesn't hurt to check.
Both of my parents are doctors. They'll take good care of me. Thank you for offering.
I'm taking you to the hospital.